and each and every step it can give that important points how to plot it for the root locus. Okay dear, wherever you have the doubt, stop that point, you can ask your doubt and clarify it. Okay, we can start now.
Yes.
All of you ready? Okay dear. Please listen the class from the beginning to end. I am saying that this topic, it is very 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 important to you, and it may be helpful for in practice, and it may be helpful for your real time example also, and it may be helpful for your future everywhere, not only for higher studies. When you go for GATE exam, government exam, any examination, without root locus or without route array, you won't find any questions. Okay, so please, without these questions, no one will frame that question paper. Please, if you have any doubt, you can ask at that moment itself. I think you know the importance of this. So please concentrate. Okay, as we discussed about the stability analysis in time domain. So in the last class, we discussed about that stability analysis using Routh-Hurwitz criterion. According to the location of the poles or according to the location of the roots, we are described that whether it is stable system, unstable system, or marginally stable system. Is it clear? And according to the range of K, I told you how to determine that. So range of K also, we can going to describe that stable, unstable, and marginally stable. You have any doubt in that points? All of you are clear about that? Routh-Hurwitz? Okay dear.
Yes.
Okay. Next, root locus plot. So all of you know the characteristic equation, 1 plus g of s h of s equal to 0. Okay. So here in the g of s, it's called as the forward path gain, h of s is called as the feedback gain. Is it clear? And you can consider that from the transfer function or from the system, we have that forward path gain and feedback gain h of s. And here we have that positive gain, positive feedback or negative feedback. So here we have that R of s, and here we have C of s. We are determining the closed loop control system transfer function is G of s divided by 1 plus G of s into H of s. You have any doubt in that? From the closed loop control system only, we can take it what is the characteristic equation of s. Okay, denominator of the closed loop control system equate to 0, that is called as the characteristic equation. So in the forward path, you can include that K and G dash of s, that total combination we can call as G of s. You have any doubt in that? So 1 plus G of s h of s is equal to 0, G of s is K into G dash of s, so we will get that characteristic equation is G of s, you can change it into K into G dash of s. So 1 plus K into G dash of s into H of s equal to 0. Here K is called as the variable parameter. What is K? K is called as the forward path gain or gain of the amplifier in the forward path. Or some people will be called as the system gain or called as the system gain. Any doubt in that? In the G of S, so in the previous system, we have analyzed that G of S and closed loop control system transfer function, we can get G of S divided by 1 plus G of S into H of S according to the absorption of the rule. This is called as the closed loop control system transfer function. So closed loop control system transfer function denominator you can equate to 0, we will get the characteristic equation. You can see in the diagram, the G of S, it's nothing but K into G dash of S. Here K is called as the forward path gain or amplifier gain, or we can call it as the system gain. So in the characteristic equation, it becomes 1 plus G of S is K into G dash of S into H of S. Here K is called as the variable parameter. Now we can going to vary the value of K from minus infinity to plus infinity. Then each separate value of K, we can get the separate locations of the roots of the characteristic equation. If all such locations you can join, the resulting plot is called as the root locus plot. Is it any doubt in that? We have that characteristic equation. Change the value of k from minus infinity to plus infinity. Each separate value of k, we will get separate set of locations of the characteristic equation. If all such locations you can join, we will get the plot. It's called as the root locus plot. Any doubt in that point? My dear students, please respond.
Sir, root plot will be like k versus the different root locations.
I'm not hearing you, dear. Sisir?
So the graph of root locus will be like one axis will be k value and one axis will be the location of root.
It's like not that. Like that, dear. You can vary the value of k. We will see later on. Okay, how we can going to plot it. Just if you are changing the value of k, we will get in this characteristic equation, you can see here, we will get different roots. When you change the value of k, different set of roots we can get. Okay, dear. So one parameter you can change, it is called as the k. Once you can complete that plot, then only you can clearly understand what is x-axis, y-axis and all. Don't confuse it now, all these things. The point is that now if you are changing the value of k from 0 to infinity or minus infinity to plus infinity, each such value of k, we will get the location of the roots for the characteristic equation. Joining all such locations, we will get the plot. That plot is called as the root locus plot. Do you have any doubt in that point?
No,
first
sir.
Listen all such points, then you can ask that complete, after completion of entire rule, you can ask your query. For this point, if you are very clear about that, what is the root locus or not? What, dear Sisir?
Yes, sir.
Sisir, you can understand at the end what you asked the question.
Yes, sir.
Okay, dear. Any doubt in that now? Because in the root locus, everything I can't explain it within the beginning step itself. Step by step procedure it is. Okay, dear. After completion of all such rules, you may ask your query. I am ready to accept it. I am saying that answers for any such type of queries. But at the beginning, what are the points I am saying? In that point, if you have any doubt, you can ask. I am ready to tell you that answers. Any doubt in that? What is root locus plot? Okay. Now, you can see that. So how we can going to define the root locus plot? When k is varied from 0 to infinity, the plot is called as the direct root locus plot. While k is varied, or when k is varied from minus infinity to 0, the plot obtained it's called as the inverse root locus plot. So in our syllabus, we can follow for direct root locus plot. It means that you can vary the value of k from
0 to infinity.
0 to infinity. Actually, root locus, it's nothing but varying the value of k from minus infinity to plus infinity, we will get separate location of the roots, and joining all such roots, we will get the plot. It is called as the root locus plot. But here itself, the root locus itself, they have two different types. One is called as the direct root locus. Next one is called as the inverse root locus. But vary the value of k from 0 to infinity, we will get the plot. It is called as the direct root locus plot. K is varied from minus infinity to 0, such plot is called as the inverse root locus plot. So we will concentrate on the first thing. Vary the value of k from 0 to infinity, we will get the plot. It is called as the direct root locus plot. We can go into describe this one. Any doubt, dear? Any doubt in that? Root locus, what is root locus? Okay, can I move next step? Just for one simple example, then I will move on to the procedure for root locus construction. Okay, so consider one simple example. Consider a unity feedback system with g of s is k by s. Obtain its root locus. How we can go to do that. Characteristic equation is 1 plus g of s into h of s equal to 0. This is the characteristic equation. G of s is k by s and it is a unity feedback. Simply you can substitute h of s is 1, g of s is k by s. 1 plus k by s equal to 0. So now s plus k is equal to 0 we will get. So roots of this equation is located as s is equal to minus k. Any doubt here? S is equal to minus k. So when you vary the value of k, when you vary the value of k, we will get different location of the roots. Okay, now I am going to vary the value of k. We will check that what is the root. So k equal to 0, we will get root equal to 0. K is equal to 1, root is equal to minus 1. K equal to 10, s is equal to minus 10. K equal to minus infinity, s is equal to minus, sorry, k is equal to plus infinity, s is equal to minus infinity. Any doubt in this? Now you can go to that S plane and you can going to mark it all the roots. So now you can start always with k is equal to 0. K is equal to 0, it's called as open loop pole. Okay dear, k equal to 0, it's called as open loop pole always. So k is equal to 0, s is equal to 0. So you can mark it here, all such points. And k is equal to 1, s is equal to minus 1. K equal to 10, s is equal to minus 10. K is equal to infinity, s is equal to minus infinity. Somewhere else. Joining all such locations, we will get the plot. It is called as the direct root locus plot here. Any doubt in that? Sisir, now you are understand?
Yes, sir.
So you can vary the value of k, we will get different roots. That's all. All such roots you can join. It's same like as S plane. In the S plane already we discussed. In the Routh-Hurwitz criterion, same procedure here. In the Routh-Hurwitz, we know that we are approximately determining where the roots are located. But here, exactly we know the location of the roots. Okay, dear. Graphical representation of the roots, where it is transverse. How the roots are located in the S-plane according to the value of k. Which range of k the system is stable. In the previous case, I told you. In the previous root locus plot, sorry, in the previous Routh-Hurwitz criterion, when the system is unstable, dear, when the system is marginally stable, when the system is marginally stable,
sir, when roots are on j omega axis and are not repeating,
and roots are,
sir, on the j omega axis and they are not repeating.
Very good, dear, very good, excellent. The same thing, you can see that suppose some poles are 0 located in the rail axis, okay. Suppose here I am saying some roots are located, some poles are located. When k value increases, suppose it is having transverse towards this direction, okay. The root will be transverse towards this direction. When k is equal to 0, it is located in the rail axis. When k value increases, the roots will be transverse any one direction, this side or this side. Okay, it will move towards one range of k, it will reach it into imaginary axis. Okay, one range of k, it will reach it into imaginary axis. Suppose k equal to 10, you can assume that it will reach it into imaginary axis. Then the root will be moved towards right hand side. What will happen now? Can you tell me?
So at k is equal to 10, it will be just stable and then it will be unstable.
Excellent, very good here. This analysis only we can going to go through that. Arshit only told, no? Who is told now, Siddharth or Arshit?
Yes.
Arshit, very good here. The same thing we can going to analyze it in graphical way. In the previous Routh-Hurwitz criterion, directly we are obtained what is the value of k. The system is marginally stable or stable. Now graphically we can going to analyze it, where the system is stable, when it will reach it into marginally stable, when it will reach it into unstable. Okay, that analysis we can called as the root locus plot. That analysis we can takes place using the plot, it is called as the root locus plot here. Are you understand? Now, Ishita, Rishad, Siddharth, Sisir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Mayank, Sushant, Abhishek, Harsh, Ashish Kumar, Deepika, Gunal Mehta. Able to follow? Able to follow, dear? Those people are not present.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Now we will move on to the steps. Okay. Before entering into the step, we will know about what is the applications of root locus. Can you tell me now what is the applications of root locus?
Sir, it is more accurate in predicting the system stability as compared to Ruth-Hurwitz.
Very good, dear. The main application is designing a system in time domain or designing a closed loop control system in time domain. And second case is to analyze the system stability in time domain. These two cases only, we can move on to that root locus plot. Okay, this is the example for root locus plot. So this example only I am going to explain it now. Okay, this I am considering as one of the example. This example only I am going to tell you how we can going to construct it for the root locus. Okay, so we will come to that point later. And this is the two applications of root locus, or these are the applications of root locus: to analyze the stability of the control system in time domain, to design a closed loop control system in time domain. Is it clear? Any doubt in that applications of root locus? Suppose you want to design a system in time domain, you can use it for the method, it is called as the root locus. And second case is to analyze the stability. Okay, to analyze the system design or analyze the system stability, we can go for root locus plot. Any doubt, dear? We'll move on to the steps. I'm expecting your answers. Please reply.
Yes.
Okay. Only two people are saying okay, yes. What about others? Sri Rock, Thirumal, Varun Bharati, Vyas.
Yes, sir.
You people are there or not? Open your mouth and see.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You're there, sir.
Okay. So each and every step you can give acknowledgement. Then only I will move on to the next step. Okay. So these are the construction rule for the root locus. Please listen. Listen. So here, this is the example I have considered for the open loop control system transfer function. For this transfer function only, the plot here it is given. Okay, this plot is called as the root locus plot. Okay, come to that point. So root locus can be constructed using G of S H of S transfer function. G of S H of S is called as the open loop control system transfer function. Any doubt here? So here you can check. So each branch of the root locus begins at an open loop pole and end at an open loop zero or zero at infinity. So root locus always originate at an open loop pole, end at an open loop zero or zero at infinity. The meaning implies that here in this transfer function, can you say how many number of poles and zeros are located? Hello dear, you are seeing this transfer function? Please acknowledge. Don't be silent. If you are silent, then I can't possible to complete the syllabus portion. It is very difficult. I am expecting your acknowledgement. Yes dear.
Two poles and two zeros.
One.
Two poles and two zeros. Six, oh dear. What is poles and zeros? Where it will be located in the transition? What dear?
Zeros are numerator equal to zero and poles are denominator equal to.
Poles are in
solution of denominator.
Okay. So numerator contains zeros, denominator contains poles. How many number of poles here, dear?
Five.
So there are five poles.
Five.
This is one pole, this second pole, this third pole. Here two poles are there, s square plus s plus 1. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 3 plus 2, 5 poles. How many zeros?
1 zeros.
Please listen, dear. Please listen. So there are 5 poles are in this problem. There are 5 poles are, or there are 5 open loop poles are exist in this transfer function. So you can mark it P is equal to 5. How many number of zeros, dear?
Only one zero.
Okay. So number of root locus branches is equal to number of open loop pole. Are you understanding my point? Number of open loop pole is equal to number of branches of the root locus. Or number of root locus branches is equal to number of open loop pole. Can you say how many number of root locus branches then?
5
root locus branches, dear. Very good. There are 5 open loop pole. Open loop pole, it is nothing but k is equal to 0. Assume that k starting value will be 0. So s is equal to minus 4, and s is equal to 0, s is equal to minus 2, s is equal to minus 3, s square plus s plus 1, it may come for minus 1 plus or minus j root 3 by 2. Okay, 2 complex poles. Okay, located in left half of the S plane. Clear? I will come to that point later. So you can assume that there are 5 open loop pole and 1 open loop zero. So I told you that number of root locus branches is equal to number of open loop pole. How many number of open loop poles now? Please acknowledge, this is very, very important. That's what I am taking that very care about that. Very slowly I am taking. Please say the answers. Whenever you can say five, the answers, sir. Only, it should be come five. For very good clarity. Yes, sir?
Five
open loop poles. How many number of open loop zeros?
One.
Okay. So there are 5 root locus branches here. Okay. So as I told you, the root locus always originate at an open loop pole, end at open loop 0 or 0 at infinity. It means that here 5 open loop poles are there. It generates the root locus branches. 5 root locus branches are exist. One of the root locus branches end at this finite 0 or open loop 0. Clear? One of the root locus branches end at this finite 0. Rest, how many root locus branches are left?
4 branches.
Yeah, rest of the 4 root locus branches end at infinity 0. Infinity 0 means when you apply k tends to infinity, it will reach it for infinite 0. Okay, rest of the root locus branches at a 0 at infinity. That's what here it is given. It will reach it at infinity, k tends to infinity, it will reach it infinite 0 or at a 0 at infinity. That's what the point. Or you understand what I said? The first point is number of root locus branches is equal to number of open loop pole. Always the root locus branches starts at an open loop pole, end at finite 0 or 0 at infinity. Is it clear? Clear my point?
Yes, sir.
Others?
Yes, sir.
If you are not understand, please tell me. Please open your mouth and say the answers. Others? I am taking the class for all 65 students, not for only 10 or 15. I have given the importance of this topic. Your future is depends upon this topic. This entire syllabus portion, year after, what we will do is everything is each and every moment it should be very, very important. Please open your mouth and say the answers. So number of open loop pole is equal to number of root locus branches. So always open loop root locus branches starts at an open loop 0, end at finite 0 or 0 at infinity. Here 5 root locus branches. So one root locus branch reach at finite 0, rest of the root locus branches move at infinity 0 or k density infinity, it will reach it for infinite zero. That is the point. Next case, determine the open loop poles given in the transfer function g of s, h of s, and mark them in the graph sheet. Okay, zeros are marked by the circle and poles are marked by the cross. Zeros are marked by circle and poles are marked by cross. Okay, accordingly, I will take it for this next page. So I will consider here S plane. What are the roots we have? Tell me, what is the transfer function we have? Tell me, how many number of open loop poles? What are the location of the poles? Pole locations?
Sir, 0, minus 2,
minus
0, minus 2, minus 3, and then minus 1, plus or minus, minus 1 it is 1, b is 1, 1 by 2, okay? So 1 by 2 is 0.5, sorry. So minus 0.5. plus or minus j root 3 by 2 when you consider s square s plus 1. Clear? Correct? It is not minus 1. Are you able to follow?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt in that? And what is the location of 0? Location
minus
of 0? Minus 4. What we have to do now?
Plot the poles.
Okay. So poles will be marked as the cross and zero will be marked as the circle. So one pole at origin. So you can put it cross. Next, one pole at minus 2. I will put it minus 2 here. Next, one pole at minus 3. Rest of the two poles are located at minus 0.5 plus or minus j root 3 by 2. So I'll consider this is 0.5, this is root 3 by 2. So two roots, minus 0.5 plus or minus j root 3 by 2. This is minus j root 3 by 2. Next, one more pole, one more zero, where it is located? Where it is located?
So minus 4.
Minus 4. So you can mark it as minus 4. So 0 will be marked as circle. Any doubt in that? Okay. Now, second point, it is very, 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 very important point. Please listen carefully. Okay, so here we have that poles and zeros in the real axis. The entire real axis, or divide the entire real axis into segments for the poles and zeros. Okay, poles and zeros, or divide the axis into segments. Are able to follow? Here to here we can call it as one axis, one segment. Here to here, one segment. Here to here, one segment. We are discussing about that real axis. Entire real axis, or divide the entire real axis into segments of the poles and zeros. Or poles and zeros divide the real axis into segments. So part of the segments will involve for the root locus. The number of poles and zeros is right half of the segment is odd. Are you able to follow? Entire segment in the left half of the S plane, or you can see that in the real axis, divides the axis into segments. The poles and zeros are divides the axis into segments. The number of poles and zeros will be equal to odd in right half of the segment. Then that segment will involve for part of the root locus. Or that will be the root locus segment. Are you able to follow what I said? Understanding my point? Okay, I will just show it what it is given. Determine the segment of the root locus on the real axis. The real axis poles and zeros divides the axis into segments. Okay, the real axis poles and zeros divides the axis into segments. A real axis segment is the part of the root locus. The number of poles and zeros to the right of the segment is odd. Are you able to understand this point? Be frank and tell me the answer.
Yes, sir. And also, can I show an example?
I will tell you. Don't worry. Just I am asking you whether you are understanding or not. I haven't explained this point. I will explain that. Then you can very clearly know about it. Okay, dear. So as I told you, the real axis segment is the part of the root locus. If the number of poles and zeros to the right of the segment is odd. Okay, come to that point. Okay. So consider only the real axis plane. Okay, don't consider about the complex poles. Okay, dear. Able to follow? So consider here we have one pole and here we have another pole. So here you can see that here to here one segment, here to here another segment, here to the end. That means RK tends to infinity, we will get infinite zero. That is having one more segment. Okay, dear. Segment. Here to here one segment. The real axis divides the axis into segments for real axis poles and zeros. The part of the segment will involve for the root locus when the number of poles and zeros in right half of the segment is odd. Now, first pole is starting here. Okay, dear. First pole is starting here. Consider only this pole. Okay. 1 minute, please. Okay. I'm considered only this pole. Please listen carefully. Okay, one pole lying at origin, another pole is s is equal to minus 2, and another pole s is equal to minus 3, another 0, we have s is equal to minus 4. Okay, these are the poles and zeros. Now, you no need to worry about that complex poles. Okay, only you can consider about the real axis poles, poles and zeros. Now, first pole where it is starting?
So zero.
Zero. Now, you forget about rest of the poles. Okay, forget about rest of the pole. Now, you can see after this side is called as the right half of the segment. Okay. This side, it is called as the right half of the segment. Are you able to follow what I am saying? Please, dear. So, you can consider only this side. You can put it your hand here. This point, you can put it your hand. Before this point, you can see that how many number of poles will be located?
One.
Right half of the segment is odd. You can say that right half of the segment is odd. So, this point to next pole and zero where it should be located, that should be a part of the root locus. Able to follow? So here to minus 2, we will get the root locus segment. Are able to follow? Number of poles and zeros in right half of the segment is odd, then that part will be a part of the root locus segment axis. Okay, now minus 2, we have another pole. Now you can start your assumption. Here you can put it your hand. Now, right half of the segment, you can see how many number of poles are there?
So one.
Here you can put your hand now.
So two, sir.
Two poles are there, no? So after minus two, there won't be any root locus axis because the number of poles and zeros are even, not odd. Odd number of poles and zeros, poles as well as zero, whatever it may be, okay? Poles and zeros, right half of the segment is odd. Then that part of the segment will involve for the root locus. But now here it is even. Are you able to follow? Are you made the assumption what I am saying?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now I will highlight it in red color. From this point to next pole and zero, there won't be a root locus. Okay. There won't be any root locus. I will put it in dotted line. Able to understand? Next, where the pole and zero again?
So minus three.
You will have minus three. Now, you will put the hand this side. You can see that how many number of poles and zeros in right half of the segment?
So three.
So it is odd number. Again, after minus three, it starts that root locus axis, and where it will be end again when the pole and zero will come. Again, pole and zero will come for s is equal to minus 4. Okay, dear? S is equal to minus 4. So, minus 3 to minus 4, it will proceed for the root locus axis. The part of the segment will involve for root locus axis. Able to follow? After minus 4, any poles and zeros are there?
No, sir.
No poles and zeros. So, after minus 4, here you can see, here you can put your hand and see that how many number of poles and zeros. You can see how many number of poles and zeros.
Four.
If you put your hand at after minus 4, that is even number. Even number. So after minus 4, there won't be any root locus axis. Able to understand how to identify that part of the segment will involve for root locus? I want to explain once again.
Yes, sir. Please.
Okay. Okay, dear. Okay, dear. Don't worry. See, we have that one of the pole at origin. You have any doubt, ma?
No, sir.
Okay. Consider. Now, I will mark it poles first. So, where we have that poles? One pole will be at s is equal to minus 2. Okay. Again, we have another pole at s is equal to minus 3. And we have one zero at s is equal to minus 4. These things are located in real axis. Okay, ma? Are you clear about this point? These poles
yes.
are taken from the open loop control system transfer function. Okay, first you can mark it in the graph sheet. Once you mark it in the graph sheet, first pole, it is located here. Okay, ma?
Yes, sir.
You can put it your hand here. Okay. Just after the pole, you can put it your hand. So if you put it your hand, left half of the segment, it cannot be visible for you. Only right half you can see. In the right side, how many number of pole will be there? Are you made the assumption what I am saying? Here you can put your hand. So this side, right side, you can see that how many number of pole will be there. How many pole?
One.
Even or odd?
Odd.
Odd. So from this point, it starts for the root locus axis, or this segment will involve for the root locus axis. So starting from this point and ending at another pole and zero where it should be located. Clear? This part will be involved for root locus axis. Okay, dear. Again, you can put your hand here. If you put your hand here, how many number of poles and zeros will be there? In right
Two.
Side? Two. Even
Two.
Or odd?
Even.
Even. So after minus 2, 2, next to pole and zero, where it should be located, there won't be any root locus axis. There won't be a part of root locus segment. Are you able to follow? From this point
yes.
to this point, I will draw it in dotted line. So already we made the assumption up to this point. Okay. So now you can put your hand here. Now you can see right half of the segment. How many number of poles and zeros?
Three.
How many?
Three.
Three means it is even or odd?
Odd.
Odd. So root locus lies on real axis or not? This segment
yes.
will be lies on the root locus. Yes. So minus 3 to next to pole and zero, it should be a part of root locus. Again, you can put your hand after minus 4. How many number of poles and zeros in right half of the segment?
4.
So after minus 4 will be a part of root locus segment?
No, sir.
Why?
Because even number.
Very good. That's all. So up to minus 4, it will be present. Okay, up to minus 4, the segment minus 3 to minus 4 will be a part of root locus axis. After minus 4, there is no poles and zeros. And there won't be any root locus axis after minus 4. Because here we have even number of poles and zeros in right half of the segment. Okay, dear, any doubt?
No, sir.
Is it clear this point? That's what I told you. Each and every point are very, very important here. That assumption, very, very important. You should be very clear about that. Then only any type of problem, you may try to do that. Otherwise, very complex. Any doubt in this? Root locus lies on the real axis, dear?
No, sir.
Now it is clear? You can see, that's what. Here to here, they put it root locus axis, 0 to minus 2. And this is for minus 3 to minus 4. We also identified the same, correct? We have the root locus axis 0 to minus 2, minus 3 to minus 4. Next, as I told you in the beginning, the number of open loop pole equal to number of root locus branches. In that number of root locus branches, suppose here we have that 5 root locus branches, one of the root locus branches end at finite 0. Rest of the root locus branches end at infinity 0. How many number of root locus branches end at infinity 0? That is called as P minus Z number of asymptotes. P minus Z number of roots will reach it into infinite 0. P is called as pole. How many number of pole we have? 5. How many number of 0? How many number of 0? 1. P minus Z is 4. So P minus Z number of root locus branches end at infinity 0. Here 5 root locus branches we have, no? 1 root locus branches will be ended here, this finite 0. Rest of the 4 root locus branches, you can see this is one root locus branch, this is another root locus branch, this is another root locus branch, this is another root locus branch. These 4 branches end at infinity 0. Okay, end at infinity 0. Which direction it will be moved towards infinity 0? Roughly we cannot do that. So we can going to identify which direction it will be travel and end it into the infinity 0. That it can give that option or that idea will provided by the technique. It is called as the asymptote. Asymptotes are the one. It can give the idea how the root locus branches end at infinity 0. How many asymptote we can going to find then? Number of 4 asymptotes, because number of root locus branches end at infinity 0, that many number of asymptote we can going to identify. Any doubt in that? So P minus Z number of asymptote we required. Okay, so where you draw the asymptote, that randomly we should not be draw it. The joining point or meeting point of the asymptote we can call as the centroid. Okay, meeting point of the asymptote we can call as the centroid. How to find the centroid? So first we can going to identify how many number of asymptote is required. How many number of asymptote I told you? Number of root locus branches end at infinite 0. That is P minus Z. You should not say that 4. Here in this example it is 4. But generally we can say that P minus Z number of asymptotes. Okay, dear? Any doubt? So number of asymptote is equal to number of branches terminate at infinity or equal to number of poles minus number of zeros. I will complete within 5 minutes. Please listen. Okay. And next point, how to find its centroid? What is centroid? I told you. What is centroid? Randomly we cannot draw the asymptotes. Okay. Randomly we cannot draw the asymptote. First you can find it for the asymptote angle. So once you find the asymptote angle, where you can draw the asymptote, meeting point of the asymptote, it is called as the centroid. Centroid we can find it by using this formulae: sum of real axis pole minus sum of real axis 0 divided by P minus Z. Sum of real pole minus sum of real 0 divided by P minus Z. Any doubt in this centroid? Any doubt in the centroid? Centroid formulae?
No doubt, sir.
Okay, dear. Next, asymptote angle. How to find it for the asymptote angle? Here one formula is given, plus or minus 180 into t cube plus 1 divided by p minus z. Q value changes from 0, 1, 2 up to p minus z minus 1. Either you can use this formula, or I will give you that another formula. It's called as 2n minus 1 divided by p minus z. So here, where n value changes from 1, 2 up to p minus z. Okay, in the previous case, p minus z minus 1 and starting value of q is 0. But in this formula, here 2n minus 1 into pi. Okay, same asymptote angle pi a, you can find it by using this formula. P minus z, what is the p minus z value here?
Four.
You can substitute 1 by 1, n is equal to 1, n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3, n is equal to 4. What is the answer you will get? N is equal to 1, what is the answer? Substitute 2n, n value is 1, so it is pi by 4, very good. Suppose n is equal to 2,
3 pi by 4,
n is equal to 3, it is 5 pi by 4, n is equal to 4, it is 7 pi by 4. What is the answer you will get? 5 by 4 is 45 degree, correct? 2 pi by 4 is 135 degree. 5 pi by 4 is? What is 5 pi by 4?
225.
Very good. What is 7 pi by 4? It is for? 315. It will come as the symmetric. 45 minus 45. Where it is minus 45? 315 you can see. Okay, 315 we can write it minus 45, no? Yes or no? In the circle, we can say that 315, if you point it, 360 minus 315 is minus 45, correct? So this is minus 45. And this is 135, 225 we can write it minus 135. So always if it is odd, even number of asymptote, it may come for the symmetric. Okay, any doubt in that? We can find it for sum of real axis pole minus sum of real axis 0 divided by p minus z. Sum of real pole, what is the number of sum of real pole? What are the poles we have? One pole zero, lying at origin.
Minus 2, minus 3. And only the real part is minus 0.5, minus 0.5.
Very good, dear. Minus 0.5, minus 0.5, and 0 will be there, no?
So minus 4.
So minus of minus 4. Okay, dear. Minus of real part of the pole will be minus 4. Sum of real axis pole minus sum of real axis 0 divided by p minus z. P minus z is 4. What is the answer? Minus 5, minus 6, plus 4. What is the answer then? 2 divided minus by? Two. Minus 2. Minus 2 by 4. Correct? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So 1 divided by 2. It is minus 0.5. So you can mark it minus 0.5. 1 point here. Already we have one pole here and there. So this pole is minus root 3 by 2, this is plus root 3 by 2. And you have to use the protector and draw it asymptote angle. One asymptote angle will be plus 45, another asymptote angle will be minus 45, that is 315. Another asymptote angle will be 135, another asymptote angle will be minus 135. Properly you can make it. Any doubt up to this step? Okay, rest of the step we will discuss in the next class. Please concentrate on this. Okay, wherever you have the doubt, you can ask and interact. See how much time it is consuming. If you are opening your mouth and saying the answer, it is more interactive and it can give that more impression to others, and the class is also moving somewhat fast. Please be interact. That's what I am expecting from your side. If you are interacting, I will give you lot more information. So if you are asking some doubt, no, I can try to give more elaborate explanation about that. If you have any doubt, or if you had any doubt in that, please feel free to ask. Okay, dear. Please, before coming on to the next class, you can read any books and identify that what are the rules will be there. See, only four rules itself, it may took nearly 45-50 minutes. So understanding is very, very important in that. Time is not an issue. Anyway, I will spend some extra time also to explain it. The important thing is you may able to gain the knowledge. That's what I told you. While reading the book, you may feel that it is easy, but while solving the problem, you may feel lot of difficulty without attending the classes. So attending the class is very, very important for this type of topic. Please concentrate and attend all the classes. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day, dear all. Thank you, dear. Okay, dear. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, dear.